Welcome to iLecture Online, and in this video we're going to show you how to draw an angled bisector. In other words, we want to draw a line that takes the angle here from A to B to C, this angle right here, exactly in half. Alright, how do we do that? Again, you take a pen and you need a compass. Of course, this is going to represent my compass. I put my pen through my little loop at the end here, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a line from there to there, across there, and over here again from there to there. Now that means that this point right there and this point right there are equidistant from my point B. Okay, I'm not done yet. That's the first thing I do. Second thing I do is, again, I put my pen through the loop. I go to my first point right there, and I draw a small little arc this way. Then I keep the very same distance, I put my end right there, and then I draw another arc right there. And where those two cross, I can then make a point, and then I draw a point from B to that point right there, and that will be my angle bisector. So I just go ahead and draw a dashed line, there, go right to that point. So this line right here, the dashed line, now divides this angle in exactly two equal parts. So if this angle right here must therefore be equal to this angle right there. Therefore, we call that a bisector, and that's how it's done. Again, you take your pen, you hold the end at B, you don't really care how long it is, it doesn't matter. But once you have the distance, hold it at the same distance, draw a little line this way, and come over here, draw a little line that way. Now you know that where those two points cross, that's the exact same distance from there to there as it is from there to there. Then you take the end of your compass, put it there, and again, it doesn't matter how long it is. You draw a small little arc this way. You keep that same length. You come over here, you draw a small little arc this way where the two cross. That forms a point. Then you connect B to that point, and that will then represent the bisector of your angle. And that is how is that done. How that is done. All right.